So people who run businesses, who have incomes, who have careers, who have reputation, who have something to lose or something to protect, are silent right now. The biggest male voices in Bollywood are conspicuous in their absence and their silence because they have these big projects riding on their very buff arms and shoulders, right? Also, they make so much more money than the women, so they have so much more to lose. Corporate India is so afraid to tick off the government, they're worried their files might not move through North Block, and they will be punished into not making as much money as they're used to, so they're completely silent. So our streets right now are littered with human rights violations, with attempts to change the fabric of this secular country. Our streets right now are full of crime. And the people who have access to education and information and communication and platforms have covered those streets with a blanket of silence. When they came for Kashmir, there was silence. They came for Assam, there was silence. They came for Jamia, there was silence. They came for Uttar Pradesh, there was silence. They came for JNU, there was silence. Too much to protect, right? Too much to lose. Yes, uncle, I understand. That is true. Middle class people, why take panga now? We're middle class. Yes, I understand. That is true. So what about those people who are standing up right now? Kannan Gopinath, Kanaiya Kumar, Varun Grover, Swara Bhaskar, Zeeshan Ayub, Deepika Padukone, Farhan Akhtar, Sandhya Mridul, Shah Faisal, who's still in custody, Shaila Rashid, don't these people have families to protect? Don't they have careers? Don't they have income? Do they have nothing to lose? Lakhs and lakhs of students in universities across the country, what do they have to lose? They have everything to lose. They have our identity to lose. Our identity as a secular democratic republic. Our Mile Sur Mera Tumhara identity, they have that to lose. That's more important than an income, or a career, or a reputation, or safety. I know if you forward something, it becomes permanent. They're reading everything, they're tracking everybody. Government is reading everything, that is true. Is the government reading the Constitution? Are you reading the Constitution, uncle? You know, we don't own this Constitution. We don't own this country. It's not ours to squander. We are custodians of it for the next generation. The same family that you're protecting with your silence will one day ask you what you were doing when their inheritance was being squandered. History will ask for accountability, uncle. History will ask you. History will ask me. When history asks for accountability, this will be the answer. The grown-ups, people with jobs and incomes and reputations and businesses and things to lose, sat down. The young stood up. The young who had nothing to lose and everything to lose at the same time stood to face the oppressor. The young stood guard for the Constitution through that cold winter night. The young kept us safe. The young made sure that we have a country to hand over to the next generation. The young stood and fought. Uncle was with us in spirit. Thank you.